More than half a dozen black women from all over the U.S. have come here to Havana, Cuba to get in touch with their roots, literally through the Hair Health and Heritage and Havana Tour.
With colorful buildings and a vibrant culture, Cuba has a lot to see and do. And this group has come specifically to explore the black experience in this country.
And it's interesting to come to Havana and Cuba in general in terms of negotiating African culture and how it's been maintained and sustained here versus the United States.
Cuban history, like that of the U.S., involves slavery. This country was colonized by Spain, which is why they speak Spanish. But throughout time, many black Cubans have been able to keep parts of their native languages, religions, and culture. And that's just what this group, led by Dr. Afia M. Bilishaka, got to explore, African culture through the lens of black hair.
I advertised this experience for hairstylists, community organizers, professors, a whole bunch of different categories for people to be able to exchange their knowledge and information and their passion for the work that they do so that we could all grow together.
The Hair Health and Heritage in Havana Tour was jam-packed with activities, from an Afro-Cuban dance class to traditional meals, a block party, and even a trip to the countryside. Plus, Dr. M. Bilishaka led seminars on what she calls psychotherapy, using hair as an entry point into mental health care.
To really bring women of the African diaspora to Cuba to reconnect to our roots through our hair.
The trip was organized by the African Diasporic Alliance, or ADA, an organization created by two women from Baltimore who were inspired by their own trips to Cuba.
So my senior year, I traveled to Havana and had an incredible time. And after we graduated, we were like, let's go back. Like, let's try to move there and like stay.
Part of the ADA's mission is to make travel and study abroad more accessible to minority youth and adults, and to help people experience black Cuban culture.
How can we connect activists, educators, artists from the African diaspora and create a mobile network where we're bringing our communities together?
Some people we met in Cuba telling us race is no longer a factor in this country.
I don't think there is a racism or such in Cuba. If there is, it's just in the mind of people.
Others disagree. This man telling us he joined the Black Panthers to stay safe.
Es la única manera que tuvimos nosotros los negros en esa época de defendernos. Yo soy un Black Panther. Manolo Mayeta de Cuba, Black Panther.
The Trump administration recently eliminated one of the legal reasons Americans can use to travel to Cuba, known as people-to-people, and restricted cruise ships from stopping on the island.
The day that that was announced, our phones were blowing up and everyone was really worried that our organization was going to come to an end, that there would be no more travel to Cuba, but that's absolutely not true.
ADA's organizers want people to know there are still 11 other legal reasons to go to Cuba.
And we still qualify under many of those. So support for the Cuban people, clinics, workshops, religious activities, research are all things that we continue to do.
Hola.
They say their trips will continue. And overall, the organizers of the Hair Health and Heritage and Havana Tour hope these women and the men and women at home will learn more about Afro-Cuban culture.
I think that it's important for black Americans to know how black Cuba is. I think we get an image in the media of light skin or straight hair being a Cuban aesthetic, but the majority of people in this space are African and look like us in the United States.
Almost every aspect of Cuban culture came from black Cubans. So Cuba's known for rumba, salsa, the food. These are all things, the cigars, these are all things that came from black Cubans.
The path to true beauty is having strong roots. And so it's very important to travel so that you get a sense of the global African diaspora.